This episode has been brought to you by our super generous supporters on Patreon.
Here we are, born to be kings, we're the princes of the universe.
Oh, hi, sorry, I was just watching Highlander for the 127th time today. And pondering my own mortality, as one does. But something occurred to me after the 103rd or 4th viewing. Why? After thousands of years of natural selection and evolution, why don't we live forever, or at least much longer? In other words, why do we die? Good Stuff producers Sam Grant and Matt Weber take a good long look at their lives and try to figure out the secret to immortality.
There is an organism on Earth that exists right now that may very well be the Highlander of the biological world. The Hydra. The Hydra is a small, simple invertebrate that lives in freshwater and temperate and tropical regions, and by all accounts so far, don't appear to age. Not in the traditional sense, anyway.
This is because most of their bodies are comprised of stem cells. Most cells in our body have a specific function. Skin cells make up our skin, nerve cells make up our brain and nervous system. Stem cells are undifferentiated cells. They have no specific task, but they do have the ability to turn into any type of cell necessary. Humans have stem cells too, but they're only found within the first few days of embryonic development. The Hydra keeps these cells around for its entire life, and it can use them to continuously regenerate itself.
So if it can constantly replace damaged and dying cells, can it live forever? A study done by researchers involved seeing if there were any signs of aging when Hydra were kept in an ideal environment. They kept over 2,000 Hydra in an ideal environment for 8 years. The death rate for the Hydra was the same each year, at 1 in 167 Hydra, no matter what age that particular Hydra was. Over the 8-year study, none of the Hydra showed any signs of senescence or deterioration of cellular makeup due to aging. Any damaged or worn out cells were replaced by an ample supply of stem cells, making them effectively immortal. In the wild, Hydra don't usually achieve immortality. They die from disease, predators, or other unnatural causes.
The key to why humans die may be because of these same unnatural causes, but not in the way you would first think. When we say someone died of natural causes, we usually mean they died of old age. This isn't quite right, however. We don't die simply because we get old, we die because parts of our body start to malfunction or get infected with disease. Cells in our body continually divide, copying their genetic information with each generation. But sometimes a mistake is made, and this results in mutations. These mutations sometimes kill or damage cells, but the really bad mutations let these damaged cells continue to propagate. This is cancer. The risk gets larger over time, so because of natural selection, cells only divide a certain amount of times before they die and are replaced. There's a gene in humans called P53 that is dedicated to solely stopping bad cells from multiplying. But it isn't foolproof, and it sometimes stops working.
The thing is, the same type of gene is present in other mammals, just in a less fallible form. For instance, there's a mammal called the naked mole rat that has been discovered to be almost entirely immune to cancer. There is a similar situation in the human body in terms of organ failure. Some of our organs can regenerate, and some cannot.
Some species, however, can. The Mexican axolotl is so good at regenerating its own organs, it can not only replace missing limbs, but also parts of its brain and heart. Having the ability to prevent cancer and regenerate organs seems like a huge survival boost. You'd be able to live longer and, theoretically, reproduce more, passing more of your immortality genes onto the next generation. So in the billion years that multicellular life has existed on Earth, why haven't all animals evolved these abilities?
Why aren't we all immortal? One idea is that our genes have been selected to fail us at a certain point in order to conserve resources for the young and future generation. This, however, is thought to be largely false. For most of our time on this planet, resources were effectively infinite. We were nomads. If we ran out of food in one place, we moved on to the next. There hasn't been enough selective pressure to make this an evolutionary advantage. Not until recently have we run up against the limitations of the biosphere, and there just hasn't been enough time for this fact to have affected the inherent lifespan of the population. So why then have we evolved to die?
To explain one part of the equation, let's take a look at the Hydra again. In general, the only way that species dies is through unnatural causes.
Like being eaten.
Every day we have a chance of dying that has nothing to do with our organs or anything cellular. We could be mauled by a lion, hit by a train, or simply fall and hit our heads walking down the street. As our lives become longer, the probability of dying in a way that has nothing to do with our genetic makeup increases.
This has been especially true throughout most of the evolution that has taken place in the human species. Before the advent of modern medicine and technology, humans just didn't live that long. usually not much beyond 40 years. And it's only in the last century or so that our lifespans have suddenly increased in length, and as a consequence, the chances of dying unnaturally.
Our genes evolved thousands of years ago and still operate under the assumption that we're probably going to die before we're 40. It is theorized that this 40-year plan evolved to let us live long enough to reproduce and raise our children, and then a little longer so that we can help out with the grandkids a bit. This helps ensure our genes survive onto the next generation and beyond.
But there comes a point where sticking around any longer becomes unnecessary and even detrimental to the survival of the species. In terms of evolution, your genes see you in old age as a lost cause. There are just too many random factors and freak accidents that could kill you for them to work too hard to keep you alive.
It makes more sense for your genetic makeup to invest itself in you while you're younger and more apt to propagate the species. A certain rapid number of cellular divisions are needed early on for growth and development, which involves an intricate system of on and off switches. This intricate mechanism works better when you're younger, not so much for an older you. Basically, your genes stop caring for you when they assume, in all likelihood, that you're already dead.
Over long enough timescales, people die, species go extinct, entire landscapes disappear. If we were immortal and somehow beat the odds and didn't die from an accident, we would eventually be trapped in a world vastly altered from the one we evolved in, hopelessly out of place and time, unable to change, and ultimately unable to survive. There's just no escaping death. Not in a statistical sense, anyway.
So, what do you think? Do you want to live forever? Need to love forever! Do you have any surefire ways to be immortal? Let us know in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video if you wanted to achieve internet immortality. Special thanks to our Patreon supporters for making this episode of The Good Stuff possible. Without Patreon, this show just wouldn't happen. So, if you like this show and you want these amazing ideas to propagate into the next generation and beyond, head over to our Patreon page and support the show. Thanks for watching.